no accredited specialist in the field of religion, no matter how liberal or how atheist or whatever, none of them in a, who will have university, college, or seminary positions, none of them teach that Jesus never lived.
Children can recognize faces as early as 2 months of age. It's an important part of the bonding process with their family and friends. What about those who are long gone, though, or even religious figures? Is there a way to recreate their appearance? New methods provide the best results yet for a figure who's been notoriously difficult to portray accurately, Jesus Christ. Keep watching to see scientists recreate what Jesus' face really looked like. Proving that Jesus even existed as a real man has been a long-term process. There are two views, the mythological and the historical. The mythological view claims that he was nothing but a legend or a myth that got spread around. It has fallen out of favor with most historians. There's too much evidence against it. The historical record indicates that, whether divine or not, he was definitely a man who existed in the past. There are two elements of his life that are accepted as historical facts. The first is his baptism by John the Baptist. Then there's his crucifixion by Pontius Pilate. Historians bring up what's known as the criterion of embarrassment to explain why these events are considered so believable. Followers of a figure rarely make up anything that makes their leader look worse. Why would his believers lie and say he was baptized to cleanse his sins while also saying he was the Son of God and without sin? Why would his followers invent such a violent and frankly embarrassing death for their leader? Beyond that, there are at least 14 sources that support the existence of Jesus. They include biblical sources, such as Paul's letters and the Gospels. There are also non-Christian sources, such as the Jewish historian Josephus and Roman historian and senator Tacitus. Believers and non-believers mention him and don't deny his existence. Of course, it's not enough for everyone. Many people in the early centuries, especially the poor, left little record of their existence. The debate over who Jesus was continues to rage, so it's no wonder the debate over what an accurate physical depiction of him would look like also persists. The problem with the traditional image of Jesus. The goals of proving the existence of Jesus and showing what he looked like go hand in hand. Even his disciple Thomas refused to believe in the resurrection until he saw the Savior face to face. The image you get of Jesus depends on where you were raised. Certain traditions show him as Black, Arab, or Hispanic. The most well-known depictions begin earlier than you might think. It was spread by artists after Christianity was legalized in the early Roman Empire. They, like other cultures, portrayed him through their own lens. That art made Jesus look like people of their time. This image is the dominant one and has spread across the continent and the world. It shows him taller than his disciples with a lean frame. He also has long, flowing, light brown hair, fair skin, and light eyes. This would have made Jesus stand out amongst his disciples, who had dark skin and hair. The authors of the Bible would have mentioned such a distinction. Instead, in the Gospel of Matthew, Judas Iscariot, when he betrayed Jesus, had to tell the soldiers who Jesus was because they couldn't tell him apart from his disciples. The idea that the Western image of Jesus is filtered through a cultural lens and far from what he actually looked like is clear. The issue is that finding a more accurate one has been a struggle for scientists and historians for years. Why it's been so hard to get an accurate image of Jesus. Many faiths have clear, undisputed images of their religious figures. There are countless statues and paintings of the Greek or Hindu gods. Buddha statues are everywhere. There's a major difference between them and the existing images of Jesus. They were made by the first worshippers where these figures were first worshipped. The traditional images of Jesus were made miles away from Europe. There are no clear drawings of Jesus made by people of his time. There may be plenty of written records, but for some reason, there aren't any visual ones. Creating a clear, defined image of what he would have looked like has proven difficult. There are no physical descriptions of him in the New Testament. An Old Testament verse from Isaiah 53:2 states, quote, "He had no stately form or majesty to attract us, no beauty that we should desire him." It's generally considered a prophetic verse meant to refer to Jesus. It indicates that he looked like many other men in his era. It also hints that historians have little to look for when searching for evidence to determine what he looked like. There aren't any non-biblical records of his appearance. There are no skeletons or bodily remains available for DNA analysis. There aren't even any drawings of him found anywhere. Gathering evidence. Forensic anthropology may provide evidence. It uses methods similar to how the police solve crimes and help identify victims. In this case, they used a combination of physical, biblical, and historical evidence. Richard Neave is a retired medical artist from the University of Manchester in England. He is a co-author of Making Faces, Using Forensic and Archaeological Evidence. They used forensic anthropology to recreate famous figures such as Alexander the Great and King Midas. They realized that with the right evidence, it could help create the most accurate image of Jesus possible. That was their unenviable task, but the results were extraordinary. Physical and digital evidence. The first step was to visit the areas the Bible indicates Jesus would have lived in. The Gospel of Matthew indicates the region he would have lived and preached. Richard's team got a group of skulls from the area near Jerusalem during Jesus' lifetime. They had at least three well-preserved specimens to work with. Technology took over from there. They used computer programs to x-ray them and create slices of them. It revealed minute details, such as the measurements of soft tissue thickness. That allowed them to create a digital reconstruction of the face of Jesus. From there, they created a cast of his skull out of clay. It used layers of clay matching the thickness suggested by the computer programs. Then they molded the nose, lips, and eyelids. There were two pieces of physical evidence that the ancient skulls and computer programs couldn't provide. They didn't know the color of Jesus' hair, eyes, and skin. For that part, they looked at historical drawings from before the Bible was officially compiled. These drawings suggested that Jesus would have had dark eyes. He also would have had a beard, in keeping with Jewish tradition. Historical and biblical evidence. Biblical and historical evidence combined to provide the missing link regarding his hair. Most religious art has Jesus depicted with long hair. Biblical scholars suggest it was probably short, with tight curls. Both of these depictions contradict the Shroud of Turin. Historians say,
"The shroud is the cloth that his dead body is wrapped in. And because of the contact with the body of Jesus, that transforms and leaves a lasting mark on the cloth. And so the shroud is believed to be a holy relic because you don't get much more holy than the actual blood of Jesus."
The shroud depicts a man with long hair. The image is closer to the one the world recognizes. It's a controversial image, yet many doubt its legitimacy. At the same time, historians note that
nobody's proved it a fake yet.
Those who doubt the shroud, which seems to include Richard, note that the idea of Jesus having long hair directly contradicts 1 Corinthians 11:14. It says, quote, "If a man has long hair, it is a disgrace to him." The book is credited to Paul, who also mentions in 1 Corinthians 15:8 that he saw Jesus after his resurrection. Why would Paul write that long hair is disgraceful if his Lord and Savior had it? It's more likely that Jesus had short hair, which was common for men of the time. Historical evidence. Historical records also provide another piece of the puzzle. Was Jesus actually taller or slimmer than the majority of his disciples? The research says no. An analysis of skeletal remains show an average man of his time was 5'1" and weighed around 110 pounds. Getting a real image. The image of Jesus that Richard created is far from the traditional Western one. It depicts a dark-skinned, dark-eyed, bearded Middle Eastern man. Richard reiterates that it's only a recreation of what an adult man who lived in the same time and place as Jesus would have looked like. Forensic anthropology is a newer discipline and not an exact science. Allison Galloway is the professor of anthropology at the University of California, Santa Cruz. She notes that forensic anthropologists are akin to sculptors, differing in their techniques. She says, quote, "In some cases, the resemblance between the reconstruction and the actual individual can be uncanny, but in others, there may be more resemblance with the other work of the same artist." Now it's time to hear from you. Which historical or religious figure would you most like to see the face of? Let us know your thoughts in the comments section below.